Hi everyone. Today I'm here to present the work that we recently did on the development of smart skeletons for 3D printed living biobots. This work it is in the framework of soft robotics field, and what we are looking for is actually on achieving like highly efficient robots which are compliant when we have the properties that we can find on their on nature in some animals, for example, like self-healing, the adaptability, or their self-organization. This is not that often found in their artificial counterparts, and that's of great interest for us. As I said in the beginning, we are working with living robotics. That means that our main unit is actually the living cells. So what we do, it's to kind of reproduce the muscles in their native tissues, or try to get them in the best conditions to have them highly functional. And when we have that, we just include them in their body to just develop the bio robot that we are interested on. So some examples to depict that a little bit, it's this kind of metasoid, literally. They copy the structure and the way it's moving. And then there is also this ray, which is flowing like the normal rays that you can see in the sea, and which is actually like showing this undulatory movement. These motion patterns are of great interest because this is actually what we are going to copy for our robots to move efficiently in different conditions. That said, what we are looking for is to develop simpler designs, which are probably not found in nature, but which helps us to understand better which are the key elements to develop these soft robots. In this case, we can see one robot that it was whose body is 3D printed, and the element in the middle is based on cell-laden skeletal muscle cells, which contract and expand and at the different frequencies due to the electric field which is imposed. And then by the friction, it's just moving. But what we wanted actually is to get a robot which is swimming. So for that, what we did, it was designing in a spring-like skeleton that it had different stiffness in each edge. And that really allowed us to induce a buckling effect that allow the swimming of the robot. So what we did is to design it, simulate it, and then just print it and create the two elements to be assembled later on. Once they are assembled, what we did, it was just following up what it would happen in their natural state. So to say, they are growing, they differentiate, and then we wait for them to be ready to actually perform their contractile behavior. So once that's happening, we can observe that they are really well aligned. This is also due to the effect of this spring, which is it's constantly producing some stress or stretching the structure, which is what's happening in our body. And that's why they feel so comfortable, and they actually perform like better than they would if they wouldn't be in that conditions. This can be seen here, where you can see in the first example, how in the spring-like skeleton it is just beating without any electric field, and when we have it just in two posts, it is not happening. And also you can compare and see exactly that the forces are much higher when we have them in this spring-like skeleton or body rather than they are with the two post element that you see here. And finally, just for you to see how they really move. So inertia is playing a key role here, and we can see how they are moving as you would, like moving their arms, and it is like a step-like motion, which had been also simulated in terms of hydrodynamics, and we can see how they move much faster if we apply a higher frequency. So to say, the impulses that we are imposing in our system, they are once every 1 second, or they are every 2 seconds, and you can see here how the robot is moving much faster. This could seem that it's moving not so fast, but actually if you compare to their counterparts or their competitors, to say so, based on cardiomyocytes, is showing similar speeds. And when we actually compare them to the other only swimming robot based on the skeletal muscle cells that we can find, we see that it's actually even like 790 times much faster. I hope that you enjoy this presentation, and I wouldn't like to stop without thanking all the team that it was involved in it. I invite you to stop by the poster if you have any questions. Thank you for your time.